Importance of pricing. Pricing is a very important decision in any marketing program. This decision needs to be taken when a firm develops a new product, a firm introduces a regular product into new market, a firm enters a bids in a new concept work. Pricing must be accurate because of the product is should be priced at low. Then a decision cannot be changed so easily. On a contract, a priced product may be end up being a failure just because of its high price. Hence, pricing must be carefully planned from a very beginning. Pricing decision all directly affect the various financial objectives such as sales volume, profit margins, trade margins, rate of return on investment, a product image, advertising and sales promotion, the market share, new product development. Thus, pricing is an extremely significant element of marketing mix. Explain the various methods of pricing a product. What is the cost plus pricing? Various methods of pricing a product may be cost plus or markup pricing. In this method, an additional margin of profit is added to a per unit cost of production to decide the selling price per unit. The additional margin of profit is known as markup and generally expressed as a percentage. When the markup is based on a cost, then the markup percentage is calculated as mark minus up in rupees divided by the cost price multiplied by 100. When the markup is based on the selling price, then the markup percentage will be markup by selling price multiplied by 100. Usually a markup is stated as a percentage of a selling price. Explain the various methods of pricing a product. First one, cost up or a cost plus or a markup prices. In this method, an additional margin of profit is added to the unit cost of production to decide the selling price per unit. The additional cost of production, that is margin of profit, is known as a markup. It is generally expressed as a percentage, and when the markup is based on the cost, then the markup will be percentage as calculated, that is the markup divided by the cost price multiplied by 100. When the markup is based on the selling price, then the markup percentage will be the markup upon selling price multiplied by 100. Usually the markup is stated as a percentage of a selling price. Second one is a target return pricing. The selling price is set in such a manner that it enables the firm to get its target rate of return on the investment. Like investment in a business is 10 crore and a unit cost is 16 rupees, the target rate of interest is 20%, then the selling price is determined as follows. That is unit cost plus the desired return multiplied by invested capital divided by sales in units. So thus, as the per unit selling price of 20 rupees is a target rate of return of 20% will be achieved, provided that the sales of 50,000 units are achieved. Now, perceived value pricing. In this method, the seller's cost are not important for deciding the price of the product. Instead, what a customer believes so be product's value is considered for pricing the product. Even though a product is priced higher than its competitors, the image of product's superior value is built up in the customer's mind through advertising and sales promotion. Thus, the buyers are convinced for the higher prices. So, fourth one, going rate pricing or market-based pricing. Here, a firm bases its pricing mainly on the competitor's price. A firm might be set same price as that of a competitor, or even a higher or a lower than that. This is generally seen in a oligopolistic market, like a steel industry, paper, something like that. Now, sealed bid pricing. This method is used when the firm submits a sealed bid or a tender for a job. The firm price is based on the estimation of the competitor's pricing rather than its own cost. The firm is interested in winning the contract, and hence generally it submits a lower price bid. But at the same time, the price bid is not below the cost. Now, define and explain the channel of distribution. Channel of distribution in marketing are the channels or pathways through which the goods and services flow from the producer to the ultimate consumer. Traditionally, the channels of distribution included only the merchant, middleman, agent, broker. However, under the modern concept of integrated marketing, the channels of distribution is considered as follows: flow of goods and people, flow of ownership and risk of loss, flow of information, flow of promotion, ordering, payments and financing, flow of negotiation and transaction. Now, components of channel of distribution. The various people, institutions which are connected to each other by one or more marketing flows are the components of the channel of distribution. Generally, these components are producers, manufacturers, merchants and middlemen, such as common carriers, bankers, advertising agencies, etc. Different channels of distribution generally used in the marketing. Direct sale channel or manufacturer to consumer channel. This is a shortest channel of distribution. A product is directly available or the ultimate consumer from the manufacturer. Three alternatives are possible in this channel: sales through advertising and direct marketing, sales through a traveling sales force, sales through a manufacturer's own retail shops. Now, this type of channels is generally suitable for the industrial goods whose buyers are very specific. This channel is not popular for the wider market, that is for the consumer goods. Second channel, that is manufacturer and retailer channel. In this channel, the goods move from the manufacturer to the retailer, from where the ultimate consumers can purchase the goods. The wholesaler is bypassed in this channel. Hence, the manufacturer has to perform the function of wholesaler, such as storage, insurance, transport, inventories, etc. This channel is suitable for when the goods are perishable and speedy distribution is essential. Also, when the buyers are large retailers for departmental stores, and this type of channels is preferred: automobiles, appliances, clothing, shoes, etc. Manufacturer, wholesaler and retailer consumer channel. In this, the most frequently seen channel of distribution. This channel is suitable when the manufacturer has to limited product line, limited finance, and when the product is durable and not subject to seasonal changes or the changes in fashion, etc. And when the wholesaler can provide a strong promotional support to the manufacturer products like groceries, drugs, etc. And manufacturer, agent, wholesaler, retailer, consumer channel. In this channel, the manufacturer uses a service of agent who distributes the goods to wholesaler, who in turn sells to retailers, from where the ultimate consumers can purchase. Such channels can distribute is widely seen in textile mills in Surat, Ahmedabad, and also in agricultural markets. The agent relieve the manufacturer of marketing task, and agent receive the commissions on their sales. Manufacturer, wholesaler, and consumer channel. In this channel, the retailer is bypassed. Consumer directly approach to the wholesalers to make their purchase. In such case, the consumers are generally large and institutional buyers, such as government, consumer cooperatives, business houses, hospitals, etc. Now, 10th question, which factors influences and governs the choice of a channel of distribution? The most basic factor which govern the selection of a channel of distribution is the cost of channel. Various other important factors are nature of product. Nature of product determines to a large extent the choice of channel of distribution. Like a delicate and perishable product, a speedy and short channel of distribution is needed. Durable goods can be moved through a longer and diversified channels. Second one, nature of market. The goods which are consumer goods requires a retailer, as the consumers are numerous and they purchase in a small quantities. For industrial goods, the retailer may be eliminated when the market size is too large. There can be many channels, while in small market, direct selling is convenient and profitable. The size and average frequency of customers orders also influence the channel decision. Buying habit of a consumer also affect the sales selection of a channel. For example, desired for credit, preference for one-stop shopping, demand for personal service, etc. Specialization of middleman. If middleman can provide a desired specialized service, then they are included in the channel. The various services desired from the middleman are a strong promotional support, high market penetration, and successful marketing to a wholesaler. Fourth one, marketing environment. During the depression, a shorter and cheaper channel is preferred. During the boom, the choice of available channel is wide. Technological advancement like a cold storage facility, better packing material, faster mode of communication, etc. all have considerable impact on a distribution channel decision. Competitors. The use of channel by competitors also influence the channel decision for a producer. Write a short note on discounts and allowance. Discounts and allowance are price concession offered to the traders or buyers for the deduction from the list price or from amount of bill or invoice. They are form of indirect competition. The various forms of discounts and allowance are: first one, cash discount. It is a price reduced to buyer who pay in full cash or by check within a short period. The period to avail the cash discount is usually 10 days. The cash discount is calculated on the net amount due after the deducting trade and quantity discounts from the initial list or catalog price. Second one is a quantity discount. It is a price reduction to those buyers who buy in large quantities. They can be offered on a non-cumulative basis, that is on each order placed, or on a cumulative basis on the number of units ordered over a given period. Trade discount or a functional discount. It is given to those buyers who buy for resale, like wholesalers or retailers. It is given in a payment for marketing functions which these traders are expected to perform. Now, fourth one is a seasonal discount. It is a price reduction to those buyers who buy during the slack season, like for hotels and airlines, offer a seasonal discount in a slow selling period. Now, allowance. Promotional allowance. These are the payments or price reduction towards the dealers for participating in advertising and sales supports program, like advertising allowance, window display allowance, free samples, free display materials, etc. Now, trade-in allowance. These are the price reduction granted for turning in on item when buying a new one. Discounts and allowance are very common in wholesale and retail trade of manufactured goods. Define and explain the concept of advertising in the marketing. Development of an advertising program. Before proceeding to develop an advertising program, it is necessary to identify the target market and motivate of the buyers. For every target market, the advertising program has to be different because of the needs and demands of the market are different. Factors to be considered while developing an advertising program. Five major factors of decision are necessary in developing an advertising program. They are known as 5M of advertising. First one, mission, money, message, media, and measurement. So first one is a mission. It means that the objective and aims of an advertising program. Typically, advertising objective may be sales good, that is to achieve a certain level of sales in a certain market within a certain time. Second is the informative advertising, like inform the consumers about a new product and service and its benefit. Persuasive advertising, that is to persuade and convince the target audience regarding the effectiveness and superiority of the particular product and brand. Last one is a reminder advertising. It is to remind the people to purchase a particular product. It is used as a product which are in the market for a long time. Now, second one is a money. Money factor is considered with advertising budget of a company. The various aspects to be considered as product life stage. New product generally requires a large advertising, while established brands have lower advertising budget. The market share and consumer base. Products having a high market share and high consumer base require a less advertising expenses as a percentage of sales. Competition and crowd of advertisement. Products having a heavy competition need the heavy advertisement to be noticed. Also, if there is a crowd of advertisement in the market, a product will have to be heavily advertised. Advertising frequency. Greater frequency of an advertising requires a higher budget. Image establishment, like commodity class products like cigarette, colas, etc., requires the heavy advertising to establish a distinct image. Message. The advertising message should be such that desired results are achieved. Like to develop a creative strategy, there are four steps: message generation, message evolution, message execution, and social responsibility review. Now, fourth M is a media. Media involves deciding the most cost-effective media channel and the frequency of the advertisement. It also benefits for the advertisement which the proper media is selected. Now, it also involves deciding the timing of the chosen media, where to allocate the chosen media in terms of a geographical area, whether the optimum for advertising in local newspaper only or in a national dailies, etc. Now, fifth one is a measurement. This means evaluating whether an advertisement was effective or not. One aspect of measurement is to evaluate the communication effect of the advertising, whether it created awareness or knowledge or preference for the product or not. Another aspect is to measure the effect on sale due to an advertisement. Now explain the importance of advertising in the competitive market. Advertising stimulates the production, employment and income, leading to a rising purchasing power and better living standards. Commercialization and invention accelerated the public acceptance of innovation, new products, etc. can be realized only due to effective mass communication or the advertising. Informative advertising enables consumer to secure the relevant and adequate information about all the revealed product and their relative merits. Thus, the advertising help consumers to exercise their right to choose and buy a product or a service intelligently. Advertising facilities mass production and mass distribution, thus facilitating the lesser unit cost of production as well as lesser unit cost of distribution. Scientific management reduces the cost of distribution. Marketing research can be used to reduce the cost of all components of the marketing mix, including the advertising. Reduction in the cost enables the corresponding reduction in prices. Advertising builds up the brand preference and brand loyalty. In the long run, these are not possible under the keen competition unless the brand quality is maintained and steadily improved by the manufacturer. Thus, the consumers can get not only a goods at lower price but also goods of the standard quality and quantity. The advertising has educative value also. It teaches us to adopt new ways of life and a higher standard of living. It can educate the community to demand quality of life. Explain how the advertising message are created. Introduction. Advertising message has to be developed with a creativity because the message must catch the attention of a target audience. In addition to being creative, the message must be presented to the audience in the most effective format and in a socially responsible manner. Thus, the advertising have to follow a specific strategy or a procedure to create an effective advertising message. Strategy for creative message generation. There are four main steps to create an advertising message. First one is a message generation, message evolution, message selection, message execution and social responsibility review. First one is a message generation. The advertising message should be selected. Generally, the consumers base a message on expectation of benefits from the product, the nature and taste of consumers, how they use the particular product. and the nature of the product is also important for message generation. Several alternative ad themes as created so as to select the one which is excellent. Message evaluation and selection. The alternative message are to be evaluated and compared with each other. The criteria used for evaluation of a message are desirability, exclusiveness and believability of the message. The market research is undertaken to decide which message has a maximum appeal with its target audience. Now, message execution. The selected message should be presented to audience in the most appropriate style, format, tone and words. There are various execution styles for message like a mood or image, fantasy, musical, personally symbol, scientific evidence, technical expertise, etc. The factors to be considered for appropriate format of the advertisement are the size, color of advertisement, pictures or illustration. The tone of advertisement must be appropriate, like various tones, maybe positive tone, humorous tone or subtle tones, etc. The words of an advertise should be memorable, creative and such that they are quick on the catching attention. Social responsibility review. The advertising should be within a social and legal norms. False and deceptive advertising should be avoided. A social responsible advertisement means that the advertisement must not hurt the sentiments of a ethnic groups, any caste, any community, race or a special interest groups. Now write a short note. What are the different objectives of a sales promotion? The different tools which are used for sales promotion to fulfill the different objective, like free samples, encourage consumer, the trial exhibitions and trade fairs provides opportunities for the new products to catch the attention of consumers and resellers, etc. On a broader level, sales promotion as an element of marketing mix has two chief objectives. First one is to stimulate the buying by an ultimate consumer, to increase the selling efforts and intensity by the dealers as well as the sales personnel. Other objective of sales promotion, the following are the various purpose of the objective of sales promotion. First one, sales promotions are used to attract the attention to new products or towards any improvements in the existing products. Sales promotion offers a good opportunity to the sellers to reward their loyal customers by giving them some incentives on the purchase. It stimulates the repurchase rate of occasional buyers. Properly planned and well projected sales promotion actually enhances the image of particular brand in the eyes of the consumer. The sales promotion greatly increases the market share of those products which have high brand dissimilarity. The sales promotion tools are advantageous and cheaper for the small scale entrepreneurs as they cannot offer a huge advertising budget. Sales promotion helps a smaller brands securing the additional shelf space and added the displays. The sales promotion often help manufacturers to adjust to a short-term variation in supply and demand. The sales promotion promote the greater awareness of prices among the consumers. The sales promotions create talking point for salesmen. Sales promotions give a sense of satisfaction and pride to the customers as they consider themselves a smart shoppers when they take advantages of various incentives. Now, what are the factors to be considered while deciding the strategy for self promotion? Six main factors for decision. First one, deciding the objective of self promotion, selecting the tools, developing the program for self promotion, promoting or protesting the program, implementation and control of the program, and evaluating the results. So, first one, deciding the objective of the self promotion. The marketing objective of an organization give direction to the objective of a self promotion. The objectives of the self promotion also depend upon the target market requirement. Generally, the objectives for a consumers are encouraging purchase for bigger unit, creating the new users, maintaining the brand loyalty. Objectives of retailers are persuading the retailers to carry new items and higher inventory levels, encouraging the off-season buying, encouraging the stocking of related items, gaining entry into the new retail outlets, etc. Objective of sales force are encouraging the support for new product or model, encouraging the more prosperity or prospecting, stimulating the off-season sale. Now, selection of tool. The tool used for the sales promotion fall into three categories. Consumer promotion tool, that is the sample, coupons, cash refund offer, gifts, prizes, reduced price pack, etc. Second one is a trade promotion tool. These are used for retailers and wholesalers, include the price of allowance, free goods, etc. Business and sales force promotion tools like information. Now, experiments. Experiments mean finding out the reaction of the sale promotion. Experiments mean that tools are used to greater business leads to impress and reward the customers and to motivate the sale force to greater achievement. These include the trade shows and conventions, sale concept, especially advertising. Now, developing a program for sale promotion. While developing a sales promotion program, several factors have to be considered, such as minimum size of the incentive to be offered, conditions for participation, that is whether the incentive is offered to everybody or only for some select group of customers. Third one is the time duration of promotion and its frequency. D is a distribution vehicle. If the incentive offered is a discount coupon, then whether it will be distributed in a package, by mail, or by in advertising. Now, timing of promotion and the total sales promotion budget. It includes the administrative cost, the incentive cost multiplied by the expected number of units that would be sold on the deal, and the pre-testing of the program. The sales promotion program should be pre-tested to determine its effectiveness. For a national level campaign, the pre-testing should be done in a selected market areas with the alternative strategies. Pre-testing may be done by using the consumer's opinion about the alternative programs or by running trial test. Implementing the controlling program, proper plans should be prepared for the successful implementation and control of each sales promotion program. The implementation plan must cover the lead time and sale in time. Lead time is the time required to prepare the program prior to launching it. Sale in time begins with the promotion launch and ends when almost 95% of the deal merchandise are sold. Evaluating the results. To evaluate the results of the sale promotion program, the following methods are used. First one is a sales data method. That is, in this method, the data is obtained from the various firms engaged in a market research. On the basis of this data, marketers can analyze which type of people take advantages of the sale promotion, their purchase before and after the promotion, etc. Consumer service. Consumers are contacted and their opinion and reactions are recorded. For example, how many of them could be recall the promotion? What was their opinion about it? How did it benefit them? How did it affect their brand choice, behavior, etc.? This method provides a marketer with detailed finding out the reaction of the people in the form of sales by delivering the changing certain incentives in the different markets or the different times.